you know, agriculture is something super important to us and to our family. And as you mentioned, Canadian Agriculture Day, I think that's a huge honor for our industry to have a day that is to celebrate agriculture and to celebrate it across the country. That, you know, speaking earlier, we were talking about what this all means to me. And to me, when I think about what agriculture means, it's our deep heritage and our roots that we have within our industry. And that's something that's incredibly important to me. And I really appreciate the fact that we get a, you know, that we're going to spend a day, take a moment to celebrate the people that are in our industry. And they are truly what makes this industry strong, that they're an honest, reliable, hardworking people. And we care about what we do, that, and what we are in charge of looking after. We look after our crops and our livestock as though they're part of the family, because they are. And you know, I'm very proud of this day, because it gives us a chance to showcase our products. And here in Alberta, we produce an incredible product that's not only nutritionally great, as you know, but it's also, we produce a very environmentally friendly product. We're really proud to share our Alberta beef with our friends and our family, as well as our entire country and globally. We have an excellent global market for Canadian beef and the genetics that my family has spent years. We have exported genetics across the world for a very long time, that a lot of business and overseas.
Well, I think you talk about the pride in our agricultural industry that we're going to be celebrating next week. And one of the things that I think has been really interesting through this pandemic is the number of people who are paying attention and no longer taking for granted the extraordinary producers that put food on our tables every single day. I mean, you know, just, you know, talking to friends who, when you're suddenly not going to restaurants anymore, boy, oh boy, is the butcher shop more of a location to go to? More, you know, are you more interested in buying Canadian? Are you more looking for ways to, since we're all stuck at home and have been for so long, looking to cook in different ways? My kids have gotten huge into cooking through this pandemic, and you know, really leaning in on, you know, what we're eating, where we're eating it from, how we're supporting local farms. I think a big question around supporting local is going to be on the top of everyone's minds as we come out of this pandemic, and everyone's, you know, trying to say, okay, how do we get going again as quickly as possible? It's going to be, well, make sure you're supporting particularly those folks who've been hit hard here in Canada through the pandemic. So there's a huge awareness of that and a pride in how hard people are working, even through these difficult times, to make sure we're keeping everyone fed and supported, while at the same time we have you know, an important role to play as a trading nation on the planet. So so much to reflect on and to celebrate. But I know, as you've talked about sort of the science of things and the advances that you've made as an industry over the past decades, has come down to a lot of very precise timing and, you know, just-in-time delivery and supply chains that must have been significantly disrupted by the pandemic. Tell me how you've been able to adjust to that, and how we can make sure we're giving you the right support. So yes, the pandemic will be difficult for everyone, but we have to make sure that it's not catastrophically difficult for anyone, or as few
people.
We're
also kind of in an area of our operation that is really close. We're really close to my calving barn. So, and our cows start calving here in a couple weeks. And that is like a nonstop go time. Don't sleep, don't rest, live with them. It's crazy. You don't want to talk to me then, because my hair is really not showered.
And how many calves are you expecting in the next stretch?
So we should, we'll start in 2 weeks. We calve out about 110 cows. We should probably get about 75 calves in the first month once we start.
Wow.
It's pretty much nonstop. So they'll calve out there, and you know, it's definitely a lot of work, but that's our harvest time. So that there is our tractor and bale processor. That's what we utilize to feed the cows. We feed our cows hay that we grow on our hay lands that we own. During the summertime, they graze on native grasslands. And it's something that I'm really proud of, that a lot of these grasslands have been owned by my family for decades. And they're really important to us to ensure that they've got great nutritional qualities within those grasslands. The other thing that we kind of do, and maybe some people appreciate, some people might think we're a little crazy, but we're very proud of the native habitat that those grasslands provide to the wildlife. That it's nothing for us to see mule, white-tailed deer in the pastures with the cattle, as well as we really work hard to protect ruffled grouse in our area. It's a little bird and I love it, and it's the cutest little thing, and it scares you to bejesus when you meet it.